ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಶುಭೋದಯ. ನಾನ್ ಧಾತ್ರಿ, ಕೇರಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಲರ್ ಮಾನ್ಸಿ ಕಿರ್ಲೋಸ್ಕರ್ ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟಿವ್ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯಿಂದ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ತರಬೇತಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಈ ತರಬೇತಿ ಡಯಟ್ ರಾಮನಗರ ಮತ್ತು ಕೇರಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಲರ್ ಇವರ ಸಂಯುಕ್ತ ಆಶ್ರಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ. ಈ ದಿನದ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ 2, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್, WH ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್, ಹೋಮೋಫೋನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಈ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಂಗ್ಲ ಭಾಷಾ ಬೋಧಿಸುವ ಪ್ರಾಥಮಿಕ ಶಾಲಾ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟ ಹಾಗೆ ಎರಡನೇ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ವೆಬಿನಾರ್ ತರಬೇತಿ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮ ನೋಡಲ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ತರಬೇತಿಗಳಿಗೂ ಓವರ್ಆಲ್ ಇನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಗಿರುವಂತ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಭಾರತಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಅವರು, ಹಿರಿಯ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸಕರು ಡಯಟ್ ರಾಮನಗರ ಇವರಿಂದ ಈ ದಿನದ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ನೋಡಿ, ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಇವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ದಿನದ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳನ್ನ ಸಹ ಪರಿಚಯ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಂತ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರಗಳು. ಸೊ ಈ ಬೆಳಗಿನ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಎರಡರ ಒಂದು ಟೀಚರ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಈ ದಿನದ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೋತ್ಸಾಹವನ್ನು ನೀಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ, ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನವನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಿರುವಂತಹ, ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ತುಂಬುತ್ತಿರುವಂತಹ ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಮನಗರ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಪಂಚಾಯತ್ ಕಾರ್ಯನಿರ್ವಹಣಾ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳಾದಂತಹ ಶ್ರೀಯುತ ಇಕ್ರಮ್ ರವರನ್ನ ನಾನು ಡಯಟ್ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು CWC ಪರವಾಗಿ ಹಾಗೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ತುಂಬು ಹೃದಯದಿಂದ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಉಪನಿರ್ದೇಶಕರಾಗಿರುವಂತ ಆಡಳಿತ ಶ್ರೀಯುತ ಸೋಮಶೇಖರಯ್ಯ ಸರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಉಪನಿರ್ದೇಶಕರ ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿಯಾಗಿರುವಂತಹ ಸಿ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಅವರು ಸಹ ನಮಗೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಹಂತದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನವನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೂ ಸಹ ಅವರ ಬೆಂಬಲವನ್ನ ನಮಗೆ ನೀಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಮತ್ತು ಸಹಕಾರವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೂ ಸಹ ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ತಾಂತ್ರಿಕ ಒಂದು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಒಂದು ತರಬೇತಿಗಳನ್ನ ಮುಗಿಸಿ ಮೂರನೇ ತರಬೇತಿಯ ಎರಡನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹ ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಜೀವ್ ಅನ್ಲೂರ್ ಸರ್ ಅವರು ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಕೋಆಪರೇಷನ್ ನ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೂ ಸಹ ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪರವಾಗಿ, CWC ಪರವಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಡಯಟ್ನ ಪರವಾಗಿ ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಸಹಾಯಕ ನೋಡಲ್ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಿಸಿದಂತೆ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿಯನ್ನ ಹೊತ್ತು ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಚಂದ್ರಿಕಾರವರು, ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸಕರು ಡಯಟ್ ರಾಮನಗರ ಇವರನ್ನು ಸಹ ಈ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಅವರು ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೇ ಮುಂದುವರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಒಂದು ದಿನದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಈ ಎರಡನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ನ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಇಲಾಖಾ ಒಂದು ವತಿಯಿಂದ ಎನ್ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ GMPS ಬಿಡದಿ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರಾಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯಾಗಿ ಕಾರ್ಯವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರನ್ನು ಸಹ ನಾನು ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಂತರ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ರು ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಕಮರ್ ತಾಜ್ ಎನ್, ಇವರು ಸಹ ಅಷ್ಟೇ GUHS ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮಾಗಡಿ ತಾಲೂಕಲ್ಲಿ ಜಮಲ್ ಸಾಬ್ ಪಾಳ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರನ್ನು ಸಹ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದಿಂದ, ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವ್ರನ್ನು ಸಹ ನಾನು ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಂತರ CWC ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಇವರ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೈ ಜೋಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಶ್ರೀಯುತ ಯಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ಹುಲಿ, ಕೀರ್ತಿ ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರಜ್ಞ, ಇವರು ಮೂರು ಜನ ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇರಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಲರ್ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯಿಂದ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಸುಗಮಕಾರರಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಇವತ್ತು. ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ಹೃದಯದಿಂದ ಅವರನ್ನ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರು, ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ತರಬೇತಿ ಪಡೆಯಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕರು ಕೂಡ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ. ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರೋವರಿಗೆ, ಆಗುವವರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಈ ಸುಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನ ಕೋರ್ತಾ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ದಾತ್ರಿಯವರನ್ನ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
ತುಂಬಾ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್. ಸೊ ಇಷ್ಟ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ನಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಂಪನ್ಮೂಲ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಎನರ್ಜೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡೋಣ, ಬನ್ನಿ.
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಕೃತಿ. ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ, ಹೌ ಆರ್ ಯು?
ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗುಡ್, ಹೌ ಆರ್ ಯು?
ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗುಡ್. ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ?
ಟು ದ ಕ್ಲಸ್ಟರ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್. ಹೌ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಯು?
ಸೇಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇವನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲಸ್ಟರ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್.
Hey Pratnya, Kruti, are you chatting here? It is already late. Let us move to the meeting.
Oh, looks it's already started.
Come, let's go. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the session. My name is Kruti Satish. I am from Caring with Color. Let us begin today's session on a lighter note. We as human beings need a language to communicate. And we have so many languages to choose from. Today's webinar is about one such language, that is English. And we will be discussing about some aspects of English and how it can be transacted in the classroom.
So let's ask me a question to you, Kruti. So do you think, does grammar even matter for any language learning?
That's a good question, Pragna. Shall we ask our audience?
Yes, sure.
Dear friends, what do you think? Is grammar really important? Does it really matter? Please let us know whether the grammar really matter or not.
So there is no right or wrong answer for this question. For language learning, does grammar really matter? This is just an opinion collection. So what do you think, Kruti?
Pragna, in my opinion, grammar is one of the basic aspects that must be learned to produce and arrange words into sentences. We unconsciously use grammar all the time when we use a language for speaking, listening, reading, and writing. Actually, when we study a language, the first thing we essentially study about are the rules of the language. Isn't it, Pragna?
Yes, Kruti. Even I do think the same. So there is no escape from grammar then.
Yes, I hope so.
Now, let us have a look at the topics we are going to discuss in today's webinar. We have present continuous tense, simple present tense, WH questions, and a very interesting topic, homophones.
Dear friends, here is a grammar tree. The base of any language rests on the pillar of words. Words can be of different kinds: nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, etc., which comes together meaningfully to form sentences. So friends, what actually goes to make a perfect sentence? The sentence which gives a full meaning is a complete sentence. It has some other aspects also, like it starts with capital letters and ends with terminating punctuation marks, such as full stop, question mark, or an exclamatory mark. It always contains a noun subject and a predicate verb. Let me give an example. The train is crossing the plains. Here, the train is the subject. Is crossing the plains is predicate. And the word crossing is the verb. Pragna, can you give an example?
Birds are flying in the sky.
Okay, Pragna, thank you. Friends, here is another question for you. The shortest grammatical correct sentence in the English language is? The options are like this: go, hi, bye, hello.
ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಕ್ವಶನ್ ತಮ್ಮ ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇದೆ: ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರುವ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವುದು ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಈ ಹಿಂದೆ ಹೇಳಲಾದ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ನ ರೂಲ್ ಅನ್ನ ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅಥವಾ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಈ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗೆ ಉತ್ತರ ನೀಡಬೇಕಂತ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇವಲ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಮಾತ್ರ ಇವೆ, ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೂಡ ನಿಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ಇರಬಹುದು. ಈ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಓದಿಕೊಂಡು ಅರ್ಥೈಸಿಕೊಂಡು ತಮ್ಮ ಉತ್ತರವನ್ನ ಕಳುಹಿಸಿಕೊಡಬೇಕೆಂದು ಕೇಳಿಕೊಳ್ತೇವೆ. In the option A is the word or sentence go. Let us see how option A is correct answer. The word or sentence go is starting by the capital letter G and ending by the terminating punctuation mark, that is exclamatory mark. And moreover, it is best example for imperative sentence. We can see here the capitalization, punctuation mark, and complete meaning. Hence, option A is the correct answer for this question. Let us move on to the next topic. Jyoti, would you explain me what tenses are?
Yes, Sallappa. Dear friends, in the last webinar, we have learned a lot about the tenses. Let us recall it. Tenses rest on the pillar of three pillars of the timeline. They are past tense, present tense, and future tense. So, the past tense tells us about something that has happened already. The present tense denotes an action in the present time. The future tense denotes an action in the future time. So, example, I write a letter, I wrote a letter, and I will write a letter. Now, let us look at present continuous tense, which belong to the present tense family. Pragna, can you tell me what's happening here?
I think the pages of the book are flipping. I think some action is going on.
Yes, you are right. The pages of the book are flipping. It denotes that an action is still going on. So, present continuous tense suggests that the action that is going on. So, it is used to express the things that are happening at the time of speaking. Here are a few more examples.
The telephone on the sofa is ringing.
Thank you. The telephone on the sofa is ringing. Here, the verb is ring and ing is added to it. It shows an action is occurring now. Let us look at another example.
The teddy bears are playing on the seesaw.
Thank you. The teddy bears are playing on the seesaw. Here also, play is the verb and ing is added to form the present continuous tense.
Read the sentences below and pick the incorrect one. Just now we had a discussion about present continuous tense. Just keeping that into mind, the options are A, I am playing tennis a lot lately. Option B, I is always reading medical books. C, he is going to have a row. And D, I am dying for a coffee.
ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರ ಈ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಕೊಡಲಾದ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಓದಿ ಅರ್ಥೈಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಈ ಹಿಂದೆ ಹೇಳಿದ ಹಾಗೆ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ನ ರೂಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡದ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರುವ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ಹೌ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ ಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್? ಐ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್. Here is the subject I, which does not agree with the helping verb is. It required helping verb am. Hence, option B is incorrect one. So, what is the correct sentence of option B? I am always reading medical books.
So, friends, one more question is here now. This is also similar to the previous one. Read the sentences below and pick the incorrect one. The criteria is same here as in before. So the options are A, he is always watching his watch. B, I am trying to forget all about this. C, I am having my hair done once a month. D, we visit the museum today. So look at the options.
ಬನ್ನಿ ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಡಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಇನ್ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಡಿ ಟೆಲ್ ಅಸ್? ವಿ ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಂ ಟುಡೇ. Here, the subject we needed helping verb are, and the verb visit is needed ing form to become continuous tense. Hence, it is incorrect sentence. So, what is the correct form of option D? We are visiting the museum today. Let us move on to the next.
Dear friends, now let us have a look on Sudha and her family. This activity is to identify the present continuous tense from the given sentences, and you have to count and answer. Come, let us join Sudha in her house this evening in Bengaluru. My name is Sudha. This is our house. I am in the hall now. I am going to the kitchen. My mother is there. She is making dinner. I am very hungry. This is my mother. She is cooking dinner. Hi, Amma. Is dinner ready?
Yes, Sudha. Dinner is ready. Please call your father for dinner.
This is my cat, Subramani. He is sleeping. Wake up, Subramani.
Meow, meow.
Appa is watching TV. Appa, dinner is ready.
Okay, Sudha. I am coming.
Now, dear friends, go through the sentences there in front of you and count the number of times the present continuous tense appears in these sentences. I repeat, read the sentences and count the number of present continuous tense appears in these sentences. Look at the picture of my house. How many sentences in present continuous tense can you identify? The options are 6, 5, 3, none. So remember, we make the present continuous tense by using present simple of be, the verb plus ing. Example, mother is cooking. So take a moment to look at it.
Option A is the correct answer for this question. Let us remember Sudha's house and dialogue boxes. Yes, there were 6 present continuous tense. They are going, making, cooking, watching, sleeping, and coming. Hence, option A is the correct answer for this question. Okay, let us move on to present simple.
Simple present tense. Friends, let us add to our knowledge something more about simple present tense. The simple present tense is when you use a verb to tell about things that happen continually in the present, like every day, every week, or every month. We use the simple present tense for anything that happens often or anything that is factual. It is not as simple as its name. Simple present is used to express habits, general truths, unchanging situations, and to give instructions. Simple present comes with its own set of rules. Before going to the rules, we'll see some examples. Have a look on this, Pragya. Could you tell me what is in this picture?
It's written here, I exercise. Maybe he exercises daily.
Yes, Pragya, you're right. Exercise is his regular practice. It is called as habit. Simple present tense is used to express habits. Here is example, I exercise. One more example I give you is, he goes to walk every morning. I have my tea after breakfast. Next is general truth. General truths are for saying facts which are always true or general truths. Here is an example for general truth. That is, Bengaluru is a metropolitan city. I will give you one more example, friends. Earth revolves round the sun. The sky is blue. Give me one more example, please.
Honey Shrekna. Is sweet.
Yes, yes, Vellappa. Thank you. Next slide is unchanging situations. Now we'll move on to unchanging situation. The situations which do not change frequently and remain constant for many more days are called unchanging situations. Here is an example for unchanging situations, friends. Delhi is a large city. I'll give you one more example. We celebrate Republic Day on 26th of January. I request my friend to give one more example here.
Bangalore is our capital city, capital of Karnataka.
Yes, Pragna, very good example. Thank you. Now let us move on to give instructions. The example is, we give a lot of instructions in our daily life. Even in our classroom situations, we give many instructions to our students. Like we tell them to stand up, close your books, open the window, etc. There is also an example given here. Someone is instructing a little boy to go straight and take left turn. Now, I request Pragya, will you give me one more example?
Wash your hands neatly.
Yes, Pragya. Thank you. These are the instructions which we are giving in the present situation in our classrooms. Okay. Okay, friends. These were some of the examples for simple present tense. Now, let us have a question based on the simple present sentence and sentence rules. Look at the words below and choose the correct sequence to form a sentence. Friends, have a look on these words. Here are some words which are jumbled. Here are 7 words. You have to arrange these words in correct sequence and frame a meaningful sentence. Let me read the question for you. The question is, 1 is live, 2 is a full stop, 3 is big, 4 is house, 5 they, number 6 is in, and number 7 is ye. Here are the 2 options for you. Option A, 5167342. And option B is 5126732. Friends, I suggest you to take a paper and a pen and write down these words in a sequence of both the options.
A is the correct answer. Yes. Let us see how the option A is the correct answer for this question. If we go by the option A numbers, the first number is 5. 5 is day, then 1, live, then 6. In, then 7, 7 is A, then 3, big, then 4, house, then 2 is the full stop. Yes, it makes complete sense. Hence, it is the correct answer for this question.
Friends, here is another with a little more difficulty level. This is also an example for simple present sentence. Here the number of words are 9. You have to arrange it in the correct sequence as given in the option A and B, and post the correct answer in the poll window. The question is, look at the words below and choose the correct sequence to form a sentence. Number 1 is goes, number 2 is to, number 3 is almost, number 4 is a market, number 5 day, number 6 the, number 7 is she, number 8 every, and number 9 is a full stop. Friends, the option for you are A, 7132648 59, and B, 7126438 59. As I suggested before, I request you to write down the words in a paper and frame the correct sentence.
Option B. Let us see how it is correct answer for this. B ಅನ್ನು ನೋಡೋದಾದ್ರೆ B ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇಸ್ 7. 7 ಇಸ್ ಅ ಶಿ. Goes to the market almost every day, and lastly, full stop. Hence, the option B is the correct answer for this question. So let us move on to the next topic. Dear friends, hope you understood what my friend Taj has explained so far. Jyoti, can you give me one more example for simple present tense in a third person singular form?
I can. She sing a song.
No, Jyoti. We have to keep some spelling rules in our mind while talking about simple present tense. Here, the third person singular form.
Oh, is it so? Then tell me, what are they?
Yes, of course, Jyoti. Here, there are spelling rules to follow, especially in a third person singular form. The first rule is that we normally add s to the most of the words. For example, as you said earlier, she sings a song. Have you understood, Jyoti?
Yes, Annappa, I am.
So friends, here we can take some more examples. The words like shed become sheds, then stop become stars, love become loves, dance become dance, dances. Jyoti, what do you see in this picture?
See the example, he shuts the door before going to work.
Yes, Jyoti, you are absolutely correct. Friends, here we can see the word shut is added with S and it becomes shuts because it tells about third person. Jyoti?
Yes, Silapa. All right, but here I have a small doubt. Can we add S to the verb? Like teach, wash, etc.
No, Jyoti, we don't. There is one more rule. The second spelling rule tells us to add es to the words which are ending in sh, ch, s, x, and z. For example, the words like wash become washes, relax become relaxes, teach become teaches, dress become dresses. Buzz become buzzes. Jyoti, what do you observe in these two pictures? Can you read out the given examples?
Yes, Annappa. In the first picture, the first example is, she teaches me at home. And in the second picture, the example given is, it washes many clothes at once.
Yes, Jyoti, you are correct. Dear teachers, in the first example, the verb teach is added with es and become teaches. In a second example, the verb for wash, es is added and it become washes.
Nice, Annappa. What about the verbs ending in consonants with y? Is there any rule for this?
Yes, definitely, Jyoti. There is a third spelling rule for such words. The third spelling rule is that we have to change Y to I and add ES for the words which are ending in a consonant with Y. Let us see some examples. Words like carry, it become carries, copy become copies, study become studies. Jyoti, what do you see in the given pictures?
Yes, Annappa. Here, in the first picture, I can see the example is, my friend studies hard using many books. And in the second picture, the example is, he carries luggage at the railway station.
Yes, Jyoti, you are correct. Dear friends, here we can observe in these two examples, the verb study is changed to studies and carry is changed to carries. In these two examples, Y is changed to I and ES is added. Jyoti, hope it makes sense.
Yes, Annappa, definitely.
But remember one thing.
What is that?
At last but not least, we have to add simply S to the words which are ending with vowels with Y. I mean, we have to apply the first spelling rule. For example, the words like play become plays, buy become buys, say become says, obey become obeys. Jyoti, I hope it is clear now.
Yes, Annappa. Thank you.
Let us move on the next topic.
Dear teachers, look at these beautiful lines written by Rudyard Kipling in his book Just So Stories as early as 1902. Pragya, do you remember who Rudyard Kipling is?
I think he is a great novelist and writer of Jungle Book.
Yes, Pragya, you are right. He is the famous English poet, novelist and the author of the Jungle Book, which I like most. Do you like it?
Yes, yes, I love it.
Okay. Let me read these lines based on W.H. words. I keep 6 honest serving men. They taught me all I knew. Their names are what and why and when and how and where and who. Prince, let us see some WH words and its usage. Pragya, will you help me answering these questions from the slide, please?
Yes, Taj, sure.
Okay. Who is this, Pragya?
He is a gardener.
Yes, he is a gardener. What is he doing?
He is watering the plant.
He is watering the plant. Where does the gardener work?
He works in the garden.
Yes, you're right. He works in the garden. Why is he watering the plants?
Plants need water to live.
Yes, absolutely. He is watering the plants because plants need water to live. When does he do it?
He waters the plant every day.
Yes, he waters the plant every day. Very good, gardener. How is the plant growing?
It is growing very fast.
Yes, it's growing very fast. Friends, here some WH words are used to frame questions. As you all know, each WH word has its own indication. Now let us know what each WH word indicates in the next slide. First is the WH word who. Who is used to indicate a person? When WH word who is used in sentence, it means that we are indicating, we are asking about a person. Who is watering the plants? Who is your English teacher? Who is your favorite actor? The next word, WH word, is what. When we use what in a sentence, it means that we are asking about a thing or an action. Here is an example. What is he doing? We are asking about the action in this. What are you eating? What is there on the table? Where? Where indicates a place, as in, where does he work? If you are using where in a question, it means that we are asking about a place. Would you like to go in your vacations? Where are you going? Why? Why, of course, is used to indicate a reason. When we use why, it means that we are asking about the reason. We have to give the reason. Why do plants need water? Why were you absent yesterday? Why are you so happy today? When? When ask about the time, as in, when does he water the plants? When we use when, friends, it means that we are asking about the time. When will your bus arrive? When will you have your lunch? Now, how? Let me tell you, friends, how is not a WH word. It does not start from WH, but even though it is a family member of WH words, question words, WH words, it is also considered as a WH question. If we use how in a sentence, it means that you are asking for the amount or the way. Here is, how is the plant growing? It means that we are asking the way of growing the plants. How do you travel to school? How is your health now? Now, I hope you all understood some of the WH questions and its usage. Now, let us move on to each question, friends. Please read the paragraph, the story, and frame questions for the answers underlined in the beginning. Begin your questions with WH words only. Friends, you have to read this story. This is a very funny story and it is also activity based on WH questions. You have to read this story and you can see some sentences are underlined here. You have to go through these sentences carefully and you have to frame questions based on WH words for those underlined sentences. It's very simple. First, let me read the story for you, friends. The story is as follows. A police officer stopped a car. There are four old ladies in the car. The old lady driving as the police officer. I was driving slow at 30 kilometers per hour. As given on the board, why did you stop me? The police officer told, ma'am, on the highway, driving too slow is also a danger. Besides, 30 is a national highway number, not the speed limit. He added with a smile. Then he asked, are you all okay? The other ladies looked all shaken up and scared. The old lady replied, smiled and said, they will be all right in a few seconds. Okay, friends, we have got up the speed of 199. Oh my God. Pragya, Did you hear the speed of 199? Have you ever tried the speed of 199?
No, Taj. I just drive at 30, 40 only.
Oh, then why don't you try 199 speed?
No, Taj.
No. Okay, don't. Try also. Okay, friends, as we said before, go through the underlined sentences and frame a suitable WH question for those sentences. And
what did the police tell to the lady? Okay. So, what did the police tell? So, who stopped the car? Okay. This paragraph is just for a demonstration of how we can use a paragraph in the classroom as an activity. So, usually students answer to the given question, but when we give the answer, it is little tricky for them to phrase a question. So thank you, friends. This is a demonstration for how the activity can be used in the classroom. And here we have 5 answers underlined. And like this, we can pick any paragraph from any storybook, and that can be utilized in the classroom as an activity. Here, our focus is to make the students to frame more questions. So usually they are familiar with finding the answer, but when we tell them to frame a question, it's little tricky for everyone. So now it's time for a question again. I'm reading for you all. So Dash, do you take English class? So answer is also given here, because I want to improve my English. So look at the options now. So option A is why, B is where, and C is when, and D is how. So why do you take English class? Because I want to improve my English. So as why indicates the reason. Why am I taking the class? Because I want to improve my English. We have a classroom activity here. List of WH question words are given here, and we can utilize this activity in the classroom. Jyoti.
Pragna.
Yeah. Shall we play a game?
Pragna, I'm ready.
Okay. So here, I'll be asking you one question, and you need to answer me with another question. So idu prashnege prashne anta. So I'll be putting one question. You don't answer it directly. You just frame another question and answer it to me. I'll find the answer in that question. So who's your best friend?
Preeti.
Oh, you are answering me directly. I request you to frame a question which includes your answer.
Okay, that means my answer should be in question form.
Yes.
Okay, then where is Preeti?
Okay. So Preeti is your best friend, right? Not me.
You are my close friend, Pragna.
Okay, thank you. So one more question is here for you. What color is your toothbrush?
Why do most of the girls like pink?
Okay, it means that you too like pink, right? Next time whenever I am buying anything, I'll make sure that it's of pink color.
Thank you, Pragna.
So now we'll ask one question to our teacher friends. So now the question is, which is your favorite color? So answer to my question also should be in the question form. I request everyone to frame a sentence, frame a question which gives the answer. Why do you choose pink? Okay.
Pragna, I can also see some of our friends have been answering, what is the color of leaf? Where is my red color pen? What is the color of rose? Why blood color is red?
So very nice, Kriti. This is also a demonstration like how we can use this activity in the classroom. And we all know that kids love asking questions, and these WH words will be revolving in their mind always. Like they ask like what, where, how, when. All these words are very familiar to them. So this activity can be played with the 6th and 7th grade students. So let us move on to. So here we have one more classroom activity. This can be used for demonstration of where questions. So here we have a chart here, and the similar type of chart we can make and just stick it to the any corner or any wall of the classroom. And this parts of the house are named here. like mudroom, garage, basement, kitchen, bathroom. So just to make easy for the child to frame the question or answer. So some household items are also given here, like lamp, bathtub, car, washing machine. So looking at this, we can frame where questions. For example, here, how to use where is the question form. Like where is the car, Jyoti?
The car is in the garage.
Okay. So where is the refrigerator?
The refrigerator is in the kitchen.
Okay. So naming the parts of the house makes easy for the students to answer. And listing out the household items makes easy for the student to also frame a question using where question. So let us move to one more classroom activity here. So we have a Talktastic board game here. And here also, Jyoti, I need your help to play with me. So yes. Are you ready?
Yes, Pragna, I'm waiting to play.
Okay, we need a dice now. So I have it. Okay, so you have to roll the dice and just have to tell me what number you are getting. And we'll start from the start button. Okay?
Okay.
So roll it now.
Yes, I'm rolling now. Yes. I got the number one.
One, only one. So sorry. So come from the start button and your word is your teacher and pick any word from the inside WH question word list.
Okay. Here I will pair with who. Who okay. is your favorite teacher?
Okay. So who is your favorite teacher is your question. So now it's my turn. Let me roll the dice. Okay, I'm getting four. So 1, 2, 3, 4. In the fourth house, there is vacation. And I'm picking the word where. So where are you planning for the vacation? So this is my question. So friends, like this, we can play in the classroom or else we can tell the students to play them among themselves.
Yes, Pragna, it's an interesting game so that the students likes to roll the dice and varieties of questions will be
frame. Yes, and we can tell the students like each time they roll the dice, so just pick a, make sure that they pick a different WH question word.
Oh, Pragna, what is happening here? I think they are fighting, but where is telling, oh dear, something is wrong in the spelling here. Pragna, if I'm not wrong, the spelling of dear and bear is wrong, isn't it?
Yes, Taj. You are right, but they are not the wrong spellings. They are just the different words. And do you know what such words are called?
No, Pragna, I don't know.
Yeah, such words are called homophones.
Oh, homophones. Yes, yes, I have heard about the homophones. But I don't know what actually it means. I thought the homophone is as same as earphone, telephone, microphone. Pragna, will you please explain me about homophones and give some examples, please?
Sure, Taj. So homophones are the pair of words that sound the same but have distinctly different meaning and different spelling. Understanding homophone is an essential part of mastering the English language, both for vocabulary building and spelling. It's important for children to recognize homophones because learning them helps children to grasp the context of the sentences and words with more than one meaning. So in simple way, I can say homophones are the words which sound alike but are spelled differently. So we'll see the history of homophone here. Homo comes from a Latin word homos, which means same. The Greek word phone, which means sound. Hence we have the word homophone. So let us have a look on some of the examples here. So the examples are B-A-R-E, bear, and B-E-A-R is also a bear. So in the first picture, it is referring to foot, bear foot. They want to say that it's a bear foot. So B-A-R-E, bear, and B-E-A-R is referring to an animal here. So similarly with, as you said, D-E-A-R and D-E-E-R are also pronounced as deer. So similarly with hair, H-A-R-E and H-A-I-R. So, and also interesting example here, flower and blue. These are some of the examples for homophones.
So, Pragna, you give me a lot of enough examples and information about homophones. Now, its homophone concept is clear for me. What is this again? Bark. It is for stem of the tree as well as for the sound of the dog. Pragna, I see the spelling here is same. Can you explain me about these type of words which is spelled alike? Is this a homophone?
Yes, Taj, though it's a homophone, but further we can categorize them as homonyms. So here, B-A-R-K, bark, is referring to the stem of the tree, that is bark of the tree, and bark is referring to also the sound of the dog. So bark is, we can say that bark is a homonym. So homonyms are the words which sound alike and are spelt alike, but have different meanings in different context.
Thank you for explanation, Pragna.
So let us look at some of the examples here. Bank. So B-A-N-K, bank, is the place where we do all our financial transactions, and also we can see here a bank of the river. So similarly with fly, F-L-Y. So example here is someone is flying in the sky, a child is there, and which says that fly. And a house fly. Similarly with seal, palm and bat. So palm is referring to a tree, and also a hand, like palm, and bat, an animal, and bat is the instrument to play with ball. So we have a one more example here is the seal. So these are also some of the examples for homonyms. So the king died dash hairless and hairless. All the options are sounding the same. So I request everyone to look at the spellings and just pick the correct word. The king died dash. It's H-E-I-R-L-E-S-S, which is absolutely correct here. The king died hairless, which indicates that he was not having any successor. So he died. So Raja Varasudaran illade sattoda anta ee vakyada meaning kodutte. So now here we have a homophone crossword puzzle activity. This also can be used in the classroom. So here clues are given across and down. So one has to find, one has to read through the clues and then put the correct homophone and just pair it. For example, here is the scent, C-E-N-T, scent, and S-E-N-T. It's a homophone pair here. So likewise, I would like to give all our audience a pair of homophone and just use it in a funny way. Just create a sentence using a pair of homophone. So shall I give a pair here?
Yes, madam.
Okay. So many of our friends are also giving here new, but I would like to give eight. I request everyone to use eight, E-I-G-H-T, eight, and A-T-E, eight, in a funny way in the sentence. Or else you can use a homonym as well. So shall I tell my sentence? Okay. I ate eight apples. Okay. Very nice. I would like to add again one continuation to that. I ate eight apples along with a pair of pears. I ate eight idlis. Okay. Next pair will be hair. H-A-R-E and H-A-I-R. Eight elephants, eight. Okay. Why two bananas? Eight bananas can be a funny way. Ramu ate eight bananas. Okay. Very nice sentences here. So we'll be saving all these sentences and we'll be using these in our classroom transaction. Okay, a pair of homophone also we can see here. Many are giving here. So, hair. So now, use the hair homophone in the sentence. In the funniest way, you can try.
Pragna, one of our participants has said, the hair of hair is soft. And there is a hair without a hair.
It's a very funny sentence, Kriti. Definitely we'll use this in our classroom. Hair is without hair, okay? So hope all of us have enjoyed creating funny sentences with the homophones. So now we are at the end of our webinar. We have here the lyrics of the song, Bare Necessities. Go through the lyrics once, which is there on the screen. And just think what we can pick from this, what we can find here, any grammatical aspects we can find in the lyrics of the song. Take a moment and have a look. All of us are familiar with the song. It's a very famous song. And the lyrics of the song are also very interesting. Jyoti, you too read the song.
Yes, Pragya.
Read it. I'll be asking you one question after this.
Okay.
Okay. Let us move on to the question now. So you just read the lyrics of the popular song from the children's film, The Jungle Book. How many grammar concepts were you able to identify at a glance in the lyrics of the song? How many grammar concepts were you able to identify at a glance in the lyrics of the song? This question is for our teacher friends. So we'll have the lyrics one more time here. Just go through the lyric and tell us like how many grammar concepts we can able to identify in the lyrics of the song. So the options here are A, 1, B, 13, C, 25, and D is 30.
Pragna, I got 13.
Okay.
Yes. Dear friends, we put together small list of concepts that show up in the lyrics. When we look at it as quickly as we showed it to you, there were nouns like bear, life, pair, pronouns like I and you, contractions like don't, they will, verbs are pick, prick, and singular and plural like worries, figures of speech is alliteration, types of sentences are declarative and exclamatory. Adjectives are like prickly pear, ra, papa, and homophones. Bear, and auxiliary verbs will have punctuation marks, question mark, conjunctions, but, and prepositions, to, for. And dear friends, this is also a way of teaching concepts in the classroom. So children would like to enjoy this, as this is a very, very, very popular song.
Pragya and Jyoti, I can also see some of our participants have told that they could come up with 25 concepts, grammar concepts in that one lyrics.
We can teach many number of concepts here. So just through a glance, we have listed this.
This is also a demonstration like how we can use lyrics of a particular song and pick any grammar concept. And as everyone, like many of our friends are saying 13, we also, our friend Jyoti also found 13, and some of our friends are finding 25, which is very appreciable. And yes, there are many concepts in the particular song, and we can use it as a tool in the classroom. Now we are almost to the end of our webinar, and just I would like to ask a question to everyone. That is, the focus of grammar instruction should always be a direct teaching of rules. If you all agree, A, or agree, and if you do not agree, disagree, or you can put B. I request everyone to answer. Okay, so here there is no right or wrong answer for this question. We are sure that we cannot escape from grammar if we want to learn any language. But it again depends on the teacher and depends on the classroom that we are handling. What do you think, Kriti?
Pragna, according to me, we shouldn't be teaching direct rules of grammar. There shouldn't be direct teaching of rules. So I disagree, Pragna. That's my personal opinion.
Okay, thank you, Kriti. So friends, as we said, like this again depends on our classroom that we are handling. Sometimes it can be a direct to the adult one, and for the students, we can utilize like many activities and then make them realize the rules of that particular grammar, particular language, and this can be a fun then. So let us have a look on the journey so far. So we have seen present continuous tense, simple present tense, WH questions, and a very interesting topic, homophones. Hope we had a great fun with homophones. So thank you.
I like to thank all the resource persons, Srimati Kamar, Taj ma'am, Jyoti ma'am, Pragna Ellappa avaru, hagene Kriti avaru, tumba chanage nadaskotru, tumba beautiful agi present madidru ee dinada webinar anna. ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟೀಚೋಪಿಯಾ ಆಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತ ಕೆಲವು ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸಹ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ತರಗತಿಗೆ ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ದ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವೆಬಿನಾರ್. ಸಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡೌನ್ಲೋಡೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಟೀಚೋಪಿಯಾ ಆಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು ಕೆಲವು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ. ಆ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನ ಡೌನ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಟೀಚೋಪಿಯಾ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದು ಆ್ಯಪ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಕೇರಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಲರ್ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯಿಂದ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೇಡ್ಸ್ 4, 5, 6, 7ಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟ ಹಾಗೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್, ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಈ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟ ಹಾಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಲೆಸನ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಲೆಸನ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಲೆಸನ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್, ಸೈನ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಇದು 5E ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಲೆಸನ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ವರ್ಕ್ಶೀಟ್, ಸಿಮ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್, ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್, ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವುದು ಸೂಕ್ತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನ ನಮ್ಮ ತರಗತಿಗೆ ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ ಅಂಶ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕನ್ನಡ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇಕೋ ಆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಡೌನ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನ ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಇನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಅದು ಟೀಚೋಪಿಯಾ ಅಲ್ಲದೇನೆ DSRT ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್, ನಾವೇನ್ ದೀಕ್ಷಾ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಸಹ ಈ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಪ್ರೀತಿಯ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ 2ನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಮುಕ್ತಾಯವಾಗ್ತಿದೆ. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ.